Is using a shared Wi-Fi hotspot safe? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you've not signed up for my weekly Confident Computing email newsletter, it's free. Visit askleo.com/newsletter. Tips, tricks, and answers to questions like this one every week. Here's the question. How come connecting to a trusted public hotspot is not a big security issue since multiple devices can be connected to that same Wi-Fi, and even if one of the connected devices has malware, then my device is also under threat? Actually, a really, really good question. This was in response to a recent Ask Leo tip of the day, suggesting that you be on the lookout for fake hotspots. Well, even if you're connected to the correct and trusted hotspot, what about all those other users? Yeah, what about them indeed? I want to start with, I'll call it a little bit of philosophy. And that is simply this. There is no such thing as secure. There's no such thing as safe. There is more secure and less secure, safer and not safer. But there are no absolutes. Essentially, dealing with technology, what we're doing is risk mitigation. We are attempting to stack the deck in favor of our safety and our security and our privacy. But it's important to understand that there are no absolutes. There is always some amount of risk. So, with that, I want to talk about what I'll consider to be the three risks associated with using a public hotspot. I want to be clear, this isn't only about open hotspots. This is about any public hotspot, or for that matter, any public internet. Risk number one, the owner. When you are using somebody else's internet, be it via a hotspot or a wired connection, they become your ISP. They are providing your internet service, the very definition of the acronym, ISP. So what that means is that they have a lot of visibility into what's going on when you're using their connection. They can see who you're connecting to. A malicious owner can also intentionally cause issues. They can potentially try and hijack your connections. They can essentially try and phish you in real time without needing email. One of the more obvious scenarios is where they do what's called DNS poisoning, so that when you go to, say, google.com, you're not really going to google.com, you're going to a site that this malicious owner has set up that looks like google.com, but that instead asks you for login credentials, and of course, once you hand over your login credentials, it's not google.com at all. It's some malicious person who now has your login credentials. This is why one of the most important things that you need to do is basically trust whoever's providing the internet. Now, the good news here is that as long as you're connecting to reputable sites and places, they're not necessarily interested in phishing you or trying to do anything. They're just providing the internet as a service at the airport, at your coffee shop, at whatever. However, that leads us to risk number two, a faker. The tip of the day I referred to earlier referred specifically to making sure that you're connecting to the correct official hotspot associated with wherever you happen to be. In my case, for example, I was at the airport last week, and there I connected to CSEA, for Seattle, free Wi-Fi. And that's the official Wi-Fi that's made available throughout the SeaTac airport. However, it is possible for someone with just a laptop or even a mobile device to sit in the corner, create a hotspot, and call it something similar. They could, for example, call it SeaTac free Wi-Fi. If you were to connect through them, thinking they were the legitimate site, then they could do some of this other stuff I was telling you about as a malicious hotspot owner. They could attempt to phish you. They could attempt to redirect you. They could attempt to do a number of things that could cause you grief. Now, of course, that raises the question, how do you tell? Right. How do you know that it's the official hotspot that you're connecting to? Generally, there are two things I recommend. One is, if you can, find out the name that's supposed to be there before you connect. There may be signs, there may be a website you can investigate before you even go there that says, okay, we provide free Wi-Fi access. Here's the hotspot you connect to. Here's the name of the thing you connect to. If that's not available, and for the record, it wasn't for me when I was at SeaTac, I was thinking about this. The thing to do then is essentially see if it's everywhere, especially in large venues. That hacker is probably just going to be sitting in a corner of one of the coffee venues within the facility. That means that their hotspot is only going to have a certain amount of range. If you leave that area, if you go to a different terminal, you go to a different gate, again, in a large facility, that hotspot probably is going to disappear because it'll be out of range. And yet, the official one, which is set up to cover the entire facility, will still be there. That's what I discovered, that SEA free Wi-Fi is there across the entire facility and was easy to connect to. So that's the really, that's the thing to look into when you're concerned, when you're in these places. Honestly, the risk here is really low. I say this because while it's possible, honestly, there are better ways for hackers to use their time. They're just not doing this kind of thing at airports or at large facilities as much as we might think. So again, be cautious, but also be aware that it's not necessarily as huge a thing as some might make it out to be. Hotspot risk number three, I will call your peers, the other people who happen to be in the same place as you, all using the same hotspot. This used to be, honestly, a really big issue, especially when hotspots were mostly open, as they honestly, they still are. If you can connect to it without a password of any sort, it's an open hotspot. In general, that means that anybody within range can see what you're doing. They can see what sites you're connecting to. But, and here's the thing that's changed, is that this isn't nearly the big issue that it used to be. These days, when you connect to your bank, you're connecting over HTTPS. It's encrypted. When you're downloading your email through an email program, chances are it's being done through an SSL connection. It's encrypted. Basically, so much of the internet has moved to either SSL or HTTPS connections that it doesn't matter that somebody's listening in. Yeah, they can see what sites you're going to, but they cannot see the data that's being exchanged between you and that site because it's all encrypted. So, yes, your peers are an issue, but not as big of an issue as they used to be. Password-protected hotspots. Now, this is not when there's like a web page where you have to enter in a password. This is where you actually have to enter a password to even connect to the hotspot. Those are different. Those protect you from this kind of snooping. Those are basically have set up WPA, WPA2, WPA3 encryption on those connections so that between you and the hotspot is completely encrypted and you don't really have to worry about anybody snooping. Now, number four, and this is the one that I think a lot of people don't think about and ultimately is the root of the question that's been asked. Networking. Risk number four is networking. Think about it. When you're at home and you've got your Wi-Fi set up and you've probably got it set up with a WPA2 password, you can still connect from one machine to another on your network. In fact, if you've got network discovery enabled, it's possible that you can actually see, okay, what machines are there on my network? Well, a lot of these public Wi-Fi scenarios are exactly the same way. You could, in theory, start network discovery and see who's there. It's not uncommon. In fact, if you do it, you'll see a bunch of strange machine names that you just don't realize are the other users of that same hotspot. Now, in general, that may be disabled. And your firewall on your computer is, in all likelihood, enabled by default. This was a change that's also happened over the last few years. Your firewall is on from the get-go, which protects you from those other people doing anything to your machine, potentially even seeing that your machine exists on the network at this public Wi-Fi hotspot. However, it can be entertaining when things are misconfigured. And it's a security risk for you if you're misconfigured. The scenario that I like to tell people about is that I went to a conference some years ago before a lot of this stuff had been sussed out. And one of the individuals in the back of our room fired up his laptop and did this whole network discovery thing. And not only was he able to see which machines were in the room, he was able to see what was on their hard drives. In fact, he went so far as to leave a file on everybody else's machine that he could, that basically made it very clear how risky their current configuration was. If he could leave a file, he could most certainly steal a file. The key here, of course, is to make sure that your firewall is turned on, that you've got the appropriate security things in place, and by and large, you'll be fine. That's why I say to the person asking the question, it's not as big a deal as it used to be. As long as your security software is in place, as long as your firewall is turned on, chances are there's just not going to be a risk. Now, there are two things to consider if this is still too uncertain for you. One, consider using a VPN. Now, I say that with the caveat that the VPN may not necessarily hide your machine from the other machines on the network. It really depends on the VPN itself. But some, I believe, do. So that's one solution. The other solution, and honestly, I found myself doing this occasionally as well, don't use the Wi-Fi. Use your mobile device's connection to the mobile network. In fact, I turned the hotspot on my phone at one point so that I could connect in a situation where I couldn't connect to the Wi-Fi, but nonetheless, it was a solution. And by using my own hotspot, by using my own mobile connection, I was isolated from everything else that all of these other people might have been doing had I been sharing the connection. So, bottom line here is that honestly, over the last few years, it's not nearly as risky as it once was to use a public hotspot. There are still risks. And yes, you should be aware of them so that you can decide whether or not they are risks you are in a position to accept or protect yourself from, but you should know about them. But by and large, I just did it. Using shared Wi-Fi throughout the internet in a couple of different airports in the plane, not an issue. Perfectly safe and secure. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/158026. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.